some we don't, that the Winchboro paper failed to run our ad this week. Some of you, I see, they did run our news release, which is kind of strange because, you know, the news release is free. You don't have to pay for those. And the ad costs money. And for some reason, they got our news release in. However, they did edit our news release and made it somewhat factually incorrect. I'm sorry. It didn't really, it wasn't, to say a lie exactly, but they made some, they made a point in there that wasn't in the news release, and it wasn't 100% true either. So, I've had a nice exchange with them. I got a nice apology from them, and then I sent them a nice letter back saying that we've been doing business with Winchboro News at this church 8 years for this event and 20-something years for other events at Tinney Chapel. And I've been the one, you know, I do all my own ads. I don't have them do it. I send in a complete ad and whatever. And I told them I appreciated the work, the promotion that it helped us do. I'm glad to see some of you here tonight. However, nobody, there wasn't an ad in the paper, and I think our attendance last time was much greater when we had the ad. Doc Davis on the bass fiddle, Washtub bass fiddle. We're going to do two or three songs for you and get started off here. I also was so upset about the when the news ad not running that I forgot to print up a little program credit. But nevertheless, I've got a notepad here that tells me how who's on and who's next and this sort of thing.
So
one more thing. Just one more thing. So Doc and I are going to start off with a song that was written by Johnny Bond, a great country singer of long ago. Wrote a lot of great, some of the best country songs ever written by Johnny Bond. Played guitar for a guy named Gene Autry. You know, just a famous guy back in the day. And this is one of my favorite songs by him. Dolly Parton made a recording of this song, which, and I think maybe she may have made the best recording of this song that did it even better than the Johnny Bond. It's called I Wonder Where You Are Now.
Woo!
And though your love was even cold,
you're working you too hard. Help.
This is a 1931 Martin plectrum guitar, means four strings, and a long scale length, about 26 inches, which is way more than most six string guitars. 1931, they only made this guitar from 1928 to 1931, none before, none after. This one is the 1931, the last year we made them. I really like this guitar. Okay, I'm going to do another song here that T. Texas Tyler made famous. This is a song Willie Nelson made famous about 40 years later. So I'm going to do it again. This is one called
thank you. going to do?
I'm not sure yet.
You hadn't decided? Well, you won't do this one.
Store, she kept blowing my phone up with all these different guitars.
all brands and all that. And I said, baby, don't buy me another guitar. Don't buy me another guitar. Finally, I said, if I ever get another guitar, if I feel like I deserve it, it will be a Martin. But I threw one across the stage when I was 8 years old. So this one come in the mail. And anyway, so for the first time in, 63 years, I'm on the stage with a Martin guitar. I promise I won't throw this one, baby. But there was a song that Willie Nelson done, and it's very appropriate for these times. Lyrics are a little different, but it's bad breath is better than no breath at all. Jill dealt with a lot of that up in New Jersey for sure. Don't ever complain about nothing. Before we can walk, we gotta crawl. Halitosis is a word I never could spell. But bad breath is better than no breath at all. It's okay to say hello to me, but don't get next if you don't wanna fall. And don't think you love me till my breath melts the wall. All the bad breath is better, no breath at all. I've been huffing and puffing, sucking all night. I got feelings in the tall. The closer we get, I'm a pro. That bad breath is better, no breath at all. Most of that room.
Happy birthday, dear God. see if it was first. Seven Spanish angels.
Seven? I thought there was eight.
That could have been.
Staggering down the street. I couldn't focus. But it's pretty much cleared up. I feel a little light here right now. I'm going to make this last song. Tennessee Whiskey. PG.
That's what's wrong with you, Doug.
Yeah. If I drank some whiskey, it would put my lights up.
Or squeezes or lubricant,
you hear everything. I used to spend my nights out in the bar room. Liquor was the only love I'd known. But you rescued me from reaching for the bottom. And brought me back from being too far gone. You're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. You're as sweet as strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy. And honey, I say song on your love all the time. Go ahead, Mom.
It's been a while, you know, like Joe Dan said, we had some pandemic stuff that get in the way. We were here probably about, I don't know, about 6-8 months ago, I can't remember. But anyway, we're always excited to get to come to Tinney Chapel to play on the stage here. We do a few songs. We hope you like them. We picked out some. We went way back to get some of them. But I just noticed by looking at you, you're probably going to remember where we're going to do tonight.
That
was not very nice. You look like you're maybe close to my age. I don't know. Hand go down. We're the oldest people here. I know that. Getting as old as me, you have to sit down. You can't stand up very long. And... I think I did this one.
Mic check 1, 2, 3. Mic check 1, 2, 3. Sounds pretty good to me. Right now.
1, 2, 3, Mike. Mic check 1, 2, 3.
That's yours. Testing 1, 2, sound good to me. I don't really need a mic to make that.
You don't like it?
Got way back in the old archives and pulled out one recorded by Charlie Walker in 1960. Everybody born since 1960. It's called Who Will Buy the Wine? Not so long ago you held our baby's bottle, but the one you're holding now's a different kind. You just sit and wait to be somebody's baby, and it all depends on who will buy the wine. Whoever sets them up and tips the waitress, your kind of love that might as well be blind. You'll never know whose lips you'll soon be kissing, and it all depends on who will buy the wine.
And you never once so bad as the whole across.
You know, throughout history, men had dreams and had visions of great and wonderful things. We remember an angel came and told Joseph it's okay to take Mary for a wife. And then we saw Jacob out in the desert. We saw a ladder sitting in the heaven. The guy that wrote this song named Arthur Smith, he said he woke up. He thought he had a dream, but he saw the master standing by his bedside. He got so impressed with that, he decided to write a song. And the song he wrote, and I'm sure you heard it before, I Saw a Man. I'm going to try to do that for you guys to close out our session here. A lot of people before me. Thanks to old Johnny Cash, a lot of people. Tonight is going to be the way Ken does it. April. Last night I dreamed.
Quite an aggregation. Thanks so much, Franklin County Troubadours. Our next performer is someone who's been on the stage here numerous times before. I've also seen him down at Quitman Acoustic Bluegrass Jam an equal number of times, if not more. And he has what most of us would call the voice of a balladeer. He has excellent taste in choosing his songs, and he does a wide variety of songs. I had told him a few months ago, after I heard first heard him do this song, I think I first heard him do it at Quitman, maybe. But anyway, it was a song that I had not heard before and haven't heard anyone else do it. I don't know, you know, and I always mention this because I think it's just a great song, you know, and he does such a great job singing it. I always mention it. I tell him, hey, I'm not trying to pick your songs for you or anything like that, even when I am. You know, but James Moore has a true balladeer's voice. And balladeer in the old sense, you know, of the true musical sense. He likes songs by Marty Robbins. He likes songs by Eddie Arnold and various other people. I kind of stopped a while ago to ask his permission to do Chain to a Memory because he does that song really well. And I've always enjoyed hearing him do that too. And we're just thrilled to have James Moore here again to do his set. Always a pleasure. And it looks like Ron Lawson is going to get an encore performance here to help him out. So, here comes Chris Martinson, maybe to do the same thing.
I don't know.
But. The star of this segment is James Moore, and here he is.
I'm the third bend on the James River. Mr. James,
hard to wait to hear me.
On Tuesday night, this next Tuesday, a bunch of us are going to jam out at Maw's Cafe, Leesburg.
What's it? Oh, Maw's. Yeah, that's right. I've seen that.
So come out
Tuesday at what time?
6 to 8.
Tuesday. Okay.
6 to 8.
This is a. You want me to announce that or what?
If you like. I mean, we just jam. We just get together and pass the mic around.
Kind of. Yeah, like we did here.
You join us. Yeah, I think you did here a time or two.
One time.
One time?
Yeah, haven't done it since COVID. Is this it?
I got into three wash desks this week. The first one got me 10 of them stung me, 4 or 5 on my head, on my ears, and all over. And so I thought I was over it. The next day I was out on the back porch and I walked up to move a box. And when I did, there was one up on a large blind that we got, a whole nest of them. They hit me all over again. I got stung 5 times in. And then yesterday, I got this fly spray after them, and I killed them. So I thought it was all over. I thought I had them whipped, you know. Had a few knots on my head now. Every once in a while, Belinda put a knot on my head, but boy, these are bigger than one. She got a little mercy. And then yesterday, I walked out there, and I was fooling around there, and was using too much electricity. And through a circuit breaker. So I reached in there to flip the circuit breaker back on, and another pile of them boil out on me. And they got me again, so I don't know whether I'm coming or going anymore. Okay, here. Glasses on, get my teeth in, and I'll be ready to sing here. D.
be the evil. I'm a great fan of Marty Robbins. I think he's one of the finest musicians and songwriters there ever was. And if you want to hear songs, some memories just won't die.
You say, no, that's not going to be. You say it's over. You say it's through. Been a long, long time, but it means nothing to you. Oh, but I heard you whisper someone's name in your sleep last night. Honey, admit it. Some memories just won't die. Some memories just won't die. Some feelings just won't leave. Oh, no matter how hard you try. And I know every now and then you still think of him. I see it in your eyes. Some memories won't die. I thought my loving you would help you forget, but something tells me you're not over him yet. Something's haunting you way down deep inside. Am I losing you to a memory that won't die? Some memories just won't die. Some feelings just won't leave. Oh, no. And I know every now and then you still think of him. I see it in your eyes. The memories just won't die. Memories just won't die. Things just go away. Oh, no matter how hard you try.
Beautiful.
I'm going to try to sing this one for that he was talking about a while ago. Let's see if I can get it in the right key. It's been so long since we've sung that my voice is not what my guitar is.
Yeah.
Today, while the blossoms still cling to the vine, I'll taste you strawberry, I'll drink you sweet wine. Gideon, tomorrow shall all pass away. Here my forget all the love that is mine today. I'll be a dandy and I'll be a rover. You know who I am by the songs that I sing. I'll feast at your table, I'll sleep in your clover. Who cares what tomorrow shall bring? Oh, today, while the blossoms still cling to the vine, I'll taste your strawberry, I'll drink your sweet wine. Amelia, tomorrow shall all
Woo!
Thank you for doing that song. Thanks. Are we coming through, Chris? Is that sounding okay? James Moore sang my favorite James Moore song today. I've never heard anyone else sing that. And it's not any stretch of the imagination to say that that is just a really beautiful song, beautifully done. And I've heard him do it three or four times and have never gotten tired of it. So thank you, Jack. You know, remember the days when they used to advertise cigarettes back before we knew they killed us, you know? There was an ad for camels that said, I'd walk a mile for a camel. And, you know, I'd walk a mile to hear James Moore sing today. I really would. I appreciate him working that into his schedule. Our next performer is someone that I originally met at Quitman at the Bluegrass Acoustic Jam there. Since then, she's graduated to doing her own jam show at Kitchens in Mineola and has a jam show which also involves open mics, and that's on Thursday nights, I think. And then she does a featured artist, I think on Friday nights, maybe. Yeah, both these are Kitchens in Mineola. And she's the coordinator, operator, the person who organizes and makes sure those all go according to plan. And she's a student of James DeFore, the famous guitar instructor, who is well known for having produced a lot of guitar players who became professional guitar players and singers, Miranda Lambert being maybe the best known in these parts. And she's still studying under him, and she has mastered the guitar under the tutelage of John DeFore. And one of the things that John DeFore requires is that his students write songs regularly. So since I first met her a year or two ago at Quitman, you know, she's come a long way. She's written a lot of songs, original songs, and has stepped up her guitar playing chops, and has become really a much more, you know, I told her, I think the first time I noticed it was when she was here, you know, that she was projecting more, and she said, well, that's something that John DeFore requires also. You know, you've got to be able to project well when you're on stage, both from your instrument and from your voice and whatever. So every time I hear her perform, she's made another leap forward. So we're pleased to have her. She hails from Palestine. Her name is Jennifer Jesse, and here she is.
Thank you. So yes, John makes me write a song a week, and that's why I have these volumes and volumes of books. Because before I know it, I've moved on to the next one and forgotten the last one. But I'm going to start with the cover tonight. Mic check, okay? This is a song that Mary Gauthier wrote, and it's called Mercy Now. And I think it's so much about, well, about every day that we have mercy, but especially in what we're going through right now.
Every single one of us could use some mercy now. Every single one of us could use some mercy now.
Woo! Yes.
Well, I had a choice on some covers, but this is a song I wrote about my daughter. It's called Only Song Little Girl. She just had a birthday too. She's not so little, she turned 37.
When will you come?
weeks ago when I had this little break. We played together. We're not from Arlington, Kentucky. We're all cousins. So you can't meet anybody who's not your cousin. So it was fun. Staying at some cousin's place. We played for some cousins, but I don't know who's about them. So that's kind of what that's about. This is a song I just wrote. It's called Runaway Cowboy.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jennifer Jesse, from Palestine, Texas. Now for what you all came to see and hear. The guy who always closes our shows because no one can follow him.
He needs to stand up.
I had to pay him a lot to say that.
Well, you know, it's really easy to understand. Back in the old days when Hank Williams was still living, he always had to close the show because nobody could follow him. Bob Hope even one time said, "Don't ever put me after Hank Williams again." You know, somebody had actually put him to do a comedy routine after. This was at the Had a Call Caravan. Some of you might even remember that. Bob Hope did a comedy routine, and then after Hank Williams, you know, and you talk about trying to get someone to laugh at jokes when they want him to come back and sing Lovesick Blues one more time. You know, it's just not going to happen. Well, George is that way. He's the original Tinney Chapel troubadour, and he is the guy that we hold for last for that very good reason, that he's the best we have to offer. And we also want to remind you that even though I didn't get the programs printed for tonight, that when George finishes his set, he will invite all the musicians to come back on stage with their instruments, and he will lead all of the musicians and those of you who are in the congregational audience here will all join him in singing "Will the Circle Be Unbroken." It's the way we close the program here every month. So even though we don't have a reminder written down for you, as soon as George finishes, he'll stand up and start working on "Will the Circle Be Unbroken." And all the people who performed here tonight, come on stage, join him, and we'll sing it together. And let me just remind all of you to be safe, be careful, God be with you, come back again next month, and as long as we're able to do these shows, we hope you'll continue to come and enjoy them with us. The guy that who needs no introduction, the original Tinney Chapel troubadour, George Jordan.
I'm a big Eddie Arnold fan. So I want to do a little Eddie Arnold medley.
Love the bites, we don't know where to stretch. He keeps right on biting, and if he gets the hatch, he gets the old feeling at home. The poor feeling. I held my baby on my knee. Along came the lovely, took her out of me. I put my arms around her. I kind of loved her a stitch. I think I got the thing called a witch. Oh, I love her lips. I love them so divine. I love them cause they taste like a drop of cherry wine. I'm gonna stick to her. And if she was blue, I mentioned for her, I know she mentioned too. Well, I feel bad, my fever starts to rise. My heart goes pitter-patter when I look into her eyes. I break out in a sweat, I begin to twitch. There ain't no vaccination for the witch. Well, the Lord comes back, he don't know where to scratch. He keeps right on fighting. Just a little bit of a rush. Thank you.
I need to holler. Testing again. We just learned that there's going to be a jam out in Ma's Cafe at Leesburg Tuesday night, 5 to 7. And if you're, it's open to the public.
Six o'clock.
What time is it, Clay?
Six to eight.
Oh, okay, six to eight.
Really good.
Anybody knows where Ma's Cafe is at Leesburg, you know, on Highway 11, right here in Pittsburgh. A jam, Tuesday night, 6 to 8 o'clock. So be sure and show up for that if that's your cup of tea. Once again, thanks to everybody for coming out. Drop a coin into the tip jar if you like, and we'll appreciate it. So, congratulations again to Doc Davis on his birthday.